The new roleplay game Boundless has released to the public, but do note, they want us to stay transparent, so expect many posts and teasers as we progress. There is not many details in the game as of right now. This is primarily an alpha build. He said the first update will be released around Christmas with more information to come. But from what we can do right now, we can spot from the watchtower, explore the national park, and visit the festively decorated town. So in this video, I'm going to be giving my suggestions, my initial thoughts, and my review on the new Boundless game. It has great graphics, you know, the map is insane. So we are by a bridge currently, and I don't know if you guys can see because it's really white because of the snow, of course. But there's like a huge river below me, honestly a really detailed bridge, a bunch of mountains surrounding me. I think I'm in, I want to say in the countryside kind of. And we have our Dodge Challenger here. I do recommend these cars get changed. There's no blinkers currently. The driving is not too good in my opinion. And you can only choose from two cars. So you have this tunnel, which honestly is amazing. Right now, I'm honestly struggling to get FPS. I have no idea why. So if the game isn't too smooth for you guys on the recording, that's why. Here is the National Park. You cannot go through these little gates over here because I don't know why, but when you go in here, right, honestly a nice detailed National Park Service thing, then you try to go open the entrance gates and it doesn't work. Don't know why, but you can slide through this side like little road here and you can head into the park. So we have some signs here. It says County Airport, so we're gonna head up to the airport. This is actually my first time seeing the airport. And it's also kind of odd, the airport's in the middle of the park, which is very strange. So let's go this way. Here, I guess, is a little parking lot. Let's just keep my car right there. So if we head in here, I honestly don't know what this is. Okay, it's a little National Park Service, I guess, lounge type of place. Yep, you have a little locker room. You have, I guess, this little meeting room with a bunch of chairs. You have this office place. And you have this little, is this a upstairs? Okay, yep, it's a little, I guess, watchtower. So National Park Service, aviation, which is honestly very cool. Do note, guys, this game does not have any teams as of right now. I'm pretty sure it'll have a National Park Service team, a police team, and probably some sort of DOT team. Hopefully coming in this month or early 24. So we just have to stay tuned. Heading over to the actual airport, seems like there is a few helipads over there, a few hangars over here. I highly doubt there will be planes publicly available, maybe for a game pass or something, because of the chaos. I don't even want to go to the spawn just yet because I know there's a huge chaos. It took me about 10 minutes to get a car that was actually free from the spawn. So overall though, beautiful runway. You've even got small little details like these. This light, and then you have this ramp, my brain just stopped working, whatever this is called, you know, the runway. Yeah, I don't know what happened with my brain there. We do have a bunch of road closed signs, because obviously there are a lot of closed roads and they don't want us going past those, but that's one of them. So if you make that left turn at the park, you will be sent to the airport, but then you can't go farther than that. Just excited to see all the mountains, all the terrain, because terrain is honestly one of my favorite parts of Roblox games, and it's honestly cool to see all that type of stuff. What do we have here? Lakeside County Fire Department. Okay, so here's station 4 of the fire department. I guess you turn this way. Yep, you see this fire department, and yeah, this thing looks very nice. Let's get out here. We do have a flashlight, I forgot to mention. It goes on and off, and can't wait for nighttime so we can actually use this thing. County Fire Station 4, District 5. I highly doubt there's actually 4 fire departments in here. I think they just used Department 4 for just a more realistic feel. But yeah, so here's a little locker room. It's quite honestly annoying that they don't have any teams in the game, you know, but because I feel like if they did have teams, more people would play it and play it. I feel like just with the civilian team, it's not very interactable, but it's okay. We also have a nice gym. Excuses don't burn calories. I believe we saw this in a little teaser. So it wasn't a public gym, it was a fire department gym.
But that's okay. You have a little garage with all the fire department tools. And I do have to say, so much detail added into this game is one of the reasons why it's actually very good. You know, you can exclude how many features it has for the graphics. Like, I'd rather have better graphics than a lot of, like, small details because, like, I mean, look at this. You know how long this must have took to make? This interior by itself must have took a long time. Overall, cool little fire department over a ledge on a mountain with a view of a nice park. So I don't even know if we're still in the park or not. That's my only concern because when I was exploring the map, there wasn't really an exit for the park. Like, I just was driving, didn't see an exit, and I just was back into the city. So I don't know. Could this be a National Park Service type of fire department? I'm not sure. This is the only fire department I've come across today. And right here, we have a little trail, which I'm actually going to walk across. This is also another bug we have, developers, that whenever you put your vehicle in park and then get out of it, a parking brake goes off. So I'm not sure if that's a bug or it's done like that on purpose. I'm not sure. But then it'll just roll forward if somebody does collide with the car. So I definitely think the cars need way better improvements because it's definitely an issue. I don't know what these things are, but we have a nice little mountain view range. Okay, you have one of these rescue things, and there's a huge thing of water. This is frozen over, right? Okay, so this is really cool. This is really cool. You have a bunch of water that's frozen over, and it's like actually making me slide. The amount of realism on this ice is insane. Like, you can see the water under it, and then you have this transparent icy feeling, which is insane, and it's so realistic to me. We're gonna walk more on this track, hopefully try not to get lost because my car is all the way down there. But we've stumbled across a bridge right here, and I guess it still have this thing. The water's not frozen over right here. You can actually go into it. It's not very deep, which is probably why. But yeah, still cool little bridge, cool little waterfall over there. All right, we've made it to the end of the trail, and here is the other side of the park. If you make a right, I remember because I see that gas station over there. We're gonna have to go walk back, and unfortunately, get my car. We even have some guardrails, which is very nice, connecting to that lake. And my game is starting to lag as we come over here to the gas station. But yeah, I don't know if it's just my PC because I have a really good PC. Is this ice? Okay, so they actually have a little bit of ice in the road, I think, which is very nice because it did make me slip a bit. Yeah, definitely some ice. You can see it a little bit down there. The gas station does work. All right, I'm gonna get out, but not too close to the pump because if you do grab the pump, that happens. And when you get up, it's like kind of those things in ERLC with the fire pump, but it's like, I don't know, it gets very stuck, and then once you take. Okay, that happened. See, that's definitely something that needs to be fixed because now I have to reset and try to get a car. Slight issue. You actually can't reset your character. So I guess I'll have to move on to a new server. And this is also a quite interesting issue that is coming around with all the servers. It's the spawns. I know they're currently fixing it. This is one of the issues that you will have if you play the game. So as we take a look at spawn, you have this Adventuria store. It has a bunch of tents and survival kit tools. I think the main aspect of this game is the outdoors, the wild, the like survival. There's a lot coming with nature, and I really like nature, so I'm not complaining. It does still have a city, and we have yet to explore that, with 12 minutes and 18 seconds currently in the video. So yeah, the town here has like a lot of like buildings with no interior, but it still makes it look cool. You have a nice tennis court, I believe, there. And honestly looks very, very nice. Another closed road over there, unfortunately. Here is what I predicted to be some sort of court or town hall building. And you could see the Christmas tree from the trailer. No interior to this one, which unfortunately, because I really hope that there was going to be a little interior. You have a bunch of like Christmas type of cabins. I don't know what this is for. Maybe some sort of like Christmas event. Very few traffic lights in the game, but you do come across them. And honestly, they're very cool. I wish there were a bit more though. And I wish the city was kind of a bit bigger, because as soon as you take a few turns, it feels like you're out of the city already. And I don't like that feeling, but it is what it is, because then again, nature is very cool. And there's that bridge we started the video off. So I guess we made kind of like a 360 turn. And we're just exploring the rest of the map. I don't know what this is right here. Looks to be no interior. Might be a police department. Let me know what you guys think this building is going to be. It's definitely going to be saved for something. I highly doubt that building will stay there without an interior, especially with all the detail that's taking up. This looks to be some sort of mechanic shop. Oh, yep. Some sort of mechanic shop. I do believe there will be car customization coming to the game. Don't take my word on it, though, because I obviously don't know the future updates, but that's why you can't even go in anywhere. You can go in here. It's called Joe's Pit Stop. So yeah, basically a mechanic shop. I don't know what kind of stress that car got into, but yeah, it's kind of flipped over. Okay. And then as you stroll around, you'll just head right back to where you started. Honestly, so many details. You have the Chill and Grill Diner right there. Grill and Chill, I'm sorry. Once again, a no interior building. We're going to keep heading this way and see if there's any more things that we can check out. Ooh, here's a nice Christmas light decoration type of thing. We haven't seen too many of those around. Obviously, you have like these up here, but not really too many Christmas themed type of decorations. Then right there, you have a plaza. I want to see what this logo is. It actually has an interior. Hold on. Okay, so there is a Peak Queenstorm Queenstown. Sorry, fitness. Use other door. Oh, so they really made it. So you have to use this door over here. That is honestly cool. That's really nice detailed feature. So I did say earlier that there was only a gym in the fire department, and that's not true. There is an actual gym over here. You have a detailed front desk. Bunch of stools, chairs, trophies. You have a dream big. You have a bunch of dumbbells and the balls. OMB Fitness. Yeah, I guess it's called OMB Fitness. Studio, one-on-one classes and freestyle. So I guess this is like a fitness class place. And you have your treadmills and punching bags. And then here is the other door, which it says exit, but you can't even go out of it. And then right here, you have one of these electricity towers that's obviously gated off from here, but you can jump over it. Like these things we see in ERLC, just with a lot of detail, a lot of textures. Shout out to OMB's textures, texturers or developers. They did a absolute amazing job. Made this game to look 2 times better with all these textures. Some sort of little highway thing. The highway is not available though. If you head up there, I'll show you what happens when you head up there. Yep, as I said, there is a roadwork thingy here, so you can't even really drive on the highway. And I just slipped and almost just crashed. But the part you can drive on is really cool. They do have another barrier here. So the highway is not complete for anyone wondering. I'm just discovering new things every time, and it's honestly amazing because I had no idea all of this existed. So now we have a grocery store. Okay, you have the sale. This I guess is like a little tool store like you would see in ERLC. Not much of a grocery store actually. There is no logo on here, so hopefully they get that branded here soon. A nice little tool store, and in the back you have some containers and a little thing for trucks to load in. I have no idea what this is, but I just found it. I'm finding new stuff like every time I'm just driving around. I'm trying to actually find the watchtower, but I'm coming across all this stuff. It looks to be, oh, it's the racing track, it's the go-kart. I do believe OMB and his manager, they're like big fans of like go-karting and racing. And honestly, really cool. They have a nice all-around like racetrack here. Hopefully this gets operational, because I would love to do some races against people. You have very nice detail in here as well. One of the more detailed buildings in here. You have slow, so you can actually drive them through here, get them on the track, or do something. After trying and trying, I could unfortunately not find the tower, but you know, we're here to close off the video. Let me know what you guys do think of this game. I'm gonna give some bugs here in case any of the developers are watching. And for you guys, if you do plan on playing this game after watching this video, here are some things you should look out for. Watch out for the massive chaos in the spawn area, because the spawn area is very chaotic until they fix the spawns. The stamina bar does not actually work, as you can see in the top left here. I believe one of them is a stamina bar, and it does not work when you do sprint. The challenger does not have headlights or turn signals, which is a bummer. Most of the road signs you cannot drive through, which is an issue, especially if you are driving fast and then you slip on some ice and you crash into a road sign. Be careful, because you will get stuck. I don't know if I'm the only one, but I am having an FPS issue, so let me know down below if you are having a FPS issue. I don't know if it's just all of the cars being spawned or performance, I'm not sure, but I know I have a pretty decent PC, so it'd be a bummer if the FPS issues are only me. If you are on mobile, expect the game to come out for mobile in the coming month of 2024. Possibly earliest is probably January, or late January, starting into February. But that's pretty much all I have. Let me know down below if you have played this game. What are your favorite parts about it? What do you think should be added and changed? I personally like the game. I really hope to get some more videos and roleplays done on this while the features come in future updates. Great job to the development team of this game. You guys made it look honestly amazing. And without further ado, I'll see you all in the next one.